We still need the documents, Chris. Documents.
Documents.
Documents. Documents. Where are the documents?
Documents.
Let me see your
documents.
You don't need to see his
documents.
We don't need to see his
documents.
These aren't the
documents
you're looking for.
These aren't the
documents
we're looking for.
Now, are you going to go ahead and have those
documents
for us this afternoon?
No.
Yeah.
We're supposed to be moving in 10 days, and I'm not sure it's going to happen because mortgage lenders are not great, awful, terrible. They wait till the last minute to ask for documents that maybe you don't have on hand, like the death certificate for a cat that your family had 20 years ago, just to be certain that that's not a dependent. So if you've been following along with the vlog, with the stories, we, like 2 months ago, bought a house south of where we're living now, and because of some problems that the builders had getting materials, it got pushed out for a month. It was a new construction home. We decided not to go with something already built that was lived in because I don't want to go through the bidding war. I don't want to deal with the home inspection. There was a lot of things I didn't want to deal with. So on a whim one day, we just bought a house. And I'm about to clear out our bank account to go pay for that house in 10 days, provided the mortgage lender wants to give us a loan. They've had months, right, to get all the documents they need, to give me time to get the things that they need, like the death certificate for the cat that we had 20 years ago. But every time I submit a document to them, it seems that it's the wrong document, or not enough document, and it's driving me bananas. The last couple of days of buying a house, dealing with mortgage lenders, is the most stressful time, and I think that there's a disconnect between, like, the loan officer and maybe the underwriter and all these other people who are involved. People who seemingly have no idea what they're doing. So there's a request that comes from a person and they say, I need this document. And I say, okay, I'll submit this document. Tell me more about this document though, because I don't know what this document is. Do you have a description of this document? In which they come back and they say, yes, it's this document. This document is not a description, it's a title, and I don't understand what you're asking me. If I was to ask you for an earnest money deposit, I just need you to upload an earnest money deposit. Would you know what they're asking? Because I have no idea. So I emailed a couple of times back and forth with this secretary who just started with the company and has no idea what they're asking for. So after a couple of emails back and forth, eventually I got a little angry and my emails were strongly worded. Finally, maybe the secretary for the underwriter emailed me back and gave me a better description of what they were looking for. And after the better description, I was able to give them hopefully what they were asking for. I'm not quite positive, but I don't know. And this has gone on for months now, for 2 months, this has gone back and forth, back and forth. Whatever happened to just picking up the phone and calling somebody and saying, hey, I need this. Hopefully in 10 days, we're able to close. I submitted the final this document to the mortgage lender a couple of days ago. So maybe? If not, I mean, I'm willing to walk away from this thing. That's like how frustrated I am right now. I'm just willing to walk away and call it a day and go do something else. Aside from that, everything's going pretty good. We have a closing date, closing time, we have a home inspection time. I have to go figure out how to do a wire transfer. I've never done a wire transfer before. So I guess I have to go to the bank and have them set up a wire transfer for an unbelievable sum of money that I just don't want to part with. The other part of this is we're moving in 10 days and I am not ready for this at all. I really thought we were going to get pushed out another month so we wouldn't close until like mid-January, but that's not the case. We're closing in 10 days. Haven't packed anything, haven't bought boxes, haven't like done anything that I need to do. So I think part of what I need to do today is go get boxes. Look, I'm sorry if that was a long-winded rant about mortgage lenders. I just needed to get that off my chest. It's been really frustrating, and I'm incredibly excited for this entire process to be over. I don't think that I can go through another home purchase for a long time. I also can't live in this apartment for another month. I gotta get out of here. In the last 10 years of Amanda and I being married, we bought 3 houses, a townhouse, the last house that we lived in, and then this one. I'm done. I want it to be over. The process is a nightmare, and I'm excited. For anybody who's been following these videos, I recently had to take my car to get a transmission rebuilt. It cost me $4,000, but I got my car back. I didn't sell it or buy a new one. I had to bring it in here for the 10-day checkup, so hopefully that goes well and I can drive this thing for like 4 or 5 more years. That would be ideal. This is the wrong time for that gigantic expense, but at least it's over with.